Season 2 of the Pat and JT podcast. Oh my, now I'm here at last. The best time, always gonna be the best. Come on! Exclusively on the Herd App Media Network.
There have been a whole bunch of scenes in movies over the years. Things that come to mind right off the top of my head would be the scene in Jaws when the guys are in the belly of the boat comparing scars. You remember that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
The Sopranos when the guys are sitting around the table comparing gunshot wounds.
Yeah.
So you and I this morning before we jumped in here to record, we're comparing how old we feel. The signs of being old.
It's because I walk in and all of a sudden I see Pappy came in emoji.
Mm-hmm,
that is an everybody has the nerd emoji.
Yeah.
You know, the little person that has their little glasses on when you send a when you send something to somebody and try it, and you don't want it to sound like a smart ass. And so you put the little emoji with the glasses on.
Yeah.
Like,
I'm a nerd.
Whatever. Pat has new glasses.
I do.
And they look legit.
I've actually had them for like 2 weeks, but I knew that you clowns would make fun of me, so I kept them in my bag.
Because, yeah, nobody makes fun of me in mine, right? I have my little readers.
I'm not worried about you. Sasha would. That's why I'm keeping it in my bag. Well, so I brought it out now because I'm sick of the headaches.
Had to get the readers. Those are legit, though. Like, they aren't the $5 for six pairs from Amazon.
No, they're because
I like mine because I lose mine all the time.
And I lose things all the time, so I'm really nervous about these. Yeah, these are like legit. I don't know what brand they are, but they were free through our insurance. So I'm like, it's cheaper to get those than it is to buy $5 ones. So I just got them.
I got six pair for $5.
That's a good deal.
That's a good deal.
Yeah, so you can basically like contacts, just crunch them up and throw them away at the end of the day.
I worry. Like I'll find a pair under the bed. I found a pair under the couch. It's like the cat knocks them off a table. They end up, whatever, I drop them when I bend over to grab something in the garage and they fall off. It's like, I can't have nice things.
And if you put five pair for $5, you don't need to worry about it. So
I've got them everywhere. So there's some at work, some in the truck, some at home. They're everywhere, so I can find them. I've turned into that person because I thought about, you know, the stupid little librarian strings. And they try and make them look fancy because they're multicolored other thing. It just doesn't work.
Now, I don't know if it's Bob Haney that we've had him on our podcast. Well, he has the glasses that split in the middle and dangle down. So one eye. Those are, like, in theory, those are super cool looking.
I know it.
I don't know. I just think they're cool looking.
Really Star Trek-y.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But that's like in my, when I get to be in my 60s, I'll get those. I don't know how old Bob is. I'm not saying Bob's in his 60s. I'm just saying.
You have to be at a certain station in life.
Yes.
To pull those off.
I'm not there.
Right? Okay.
I'm not at that station. I feel like I'm at that station.
If you have glasses like that, it's because you broke them.
Right. I know exactly. Yeah, it's no cool. It's not magnetized. No. It's because I broke them. No, I feel.
I remember when I found clasps that you could put on necklaces. You can add them so they're magnetized.
Doesn't that make you nervous, though?
And they just snap together.
Doesn't that make you nervous?
So you don't have to fumble around with the clasp.
Well, yeah, but doesn't that make you nervous? Like if you like.
Shit, no. Why would it make you nervous?
Well, like it's going to. Like if you snag your necklace on something and it.
The chances of that are pretty slim.
Okay, fair enough. You said it, not me.
But
you said it.
But if you have a necklace or choker or anything like that you want to put on it, you put those little ends on them.
Yeah.
And they go together.
Brilliant.
It's you don't
brilliant.
Have to fumble around with them. Well, yeah, until somebody points out that you must be old because you can't fumble around with the clasp anymore. I'm like, no, I'm tired of it.
It's hard.
As you get older, you get tired of the BS.
Mm-hmm. No, you do.
I'm
you
tired do. Of messing with this. I don't have to do this way.
Yeah.
So, yes. But anyway.
That's like the old ladies, older ladies use clip on earrings because they're sick of
Right? Sick of trying to hold on to the backs on pierced earrings.
Yep.
Or else you get the drop ones that don't have backs
That's
on
like,
them.
I'm not at that. You're not at that station with the clip-ons yet.
No.
You're at the hookies.
I do the drop earrings. Yeah. I like the drop earrings instead. I don't like the studs. I'm not wearing. I do, but I don't. Never mind. Anyway.
Back to that whole snagging on anything. She likes the studs, but just doesn't put up with them.
Not those. I don't want to put up with them. That's the problem. That right there. Yeah. So anyway.
Yeah. We finally got around a couple weeks ago. Remember we were going to stain our deck.
Yeah.
And then we ended up digging a hole instead and making a like a patio dealy. Mm-hmm. So yesterday, Friday? No, Wednesday.
Doesn't matter.
Well, it does because on Wednesday when we got back from LA for my trip, I get home and I can tell my wife's itching. Like she wants to go out and do something. So
surprised she didn't go ahead and just do it while you're gone because it would have been easier than having you there.
Funny that plays into this story.
So I would have done that.
On Wednesday night, we go to Nebraska Furniture Mart Berkshire Days, whatever. It's extended because of COVID, apparently. Whatever. So we went there and we ended up buying a new couch. We had been saving for this couch and we wanted it. We bought a different couch, got a new couch, whatever. Got it. It was delivered, set to be delivered on Sunday morning. And so at the same time, we're looking at the weather pattern and we're like, well, we probably need to, if we're going to stain our deck, we better stain or get off the pot.
Farmer's almanac.
Right. So we ended up washing, scrubbing the deck down with the deck cleaner and letting it dry 24 hours. The next morning, get up, we were going to stain it. Well, so we, in our brilliant, infinite wisdom, we decided to not only, the couch was going to be delivered on Sunday, but to save a little money, we were just going to have the boys put it in the garage, and we would take it upstairs, take the old stuff downstairs.
Oh, hell no. Okay, so, that's all right. Okay.
So we did. They dropped it off, and then it was an I realized how, like, just feeble I feel. Like, carrying a couch down. I am so sore today from carrying a couch and chair down and then a sectional up. Yeah. And putting it together.
Yeah.
And I remember at one point I'm walking backwards. My son's helping and he's like picking the couch up, throwing it, whatever. Yeah. And I'm at the other side. And at one point I looked down and my legs were shaking, like wobbling. Like it felt like my ankles were going to pop.
Yeah.
Like it was just rough.
It's rough.
And then, and when you're in the middle of doing that, you think, oh, I'm almost done with this project. But then you got a stupid deck to stain.
Yeah.
The same, because we had already washed it. And it was going to rain potentially on Tuesday.
You're getting closer to the place where I am, where it's like, I can do it. I ain't gonna.
I don't want
to
do it.
I'm gonna hire somebody.
No,
I'm just point where I'm like, yeah, I've carried the couch. Oh, like getting the couch. We talk about this every spring and fall when I take the patio furniture and I put it in the basement, and then I bring it back up in the spring. Right?
Yeah.
I think I'm to the point. I'll probably take it downstairs this time. I don't know that I bring it back up next year.
I wouldn't.
I'm saying I'm gonna have somebody else do it, or that's where
pay
it's
one of the
stay.
Lawn guys. Give them $25. They'll do it in a heartbeat.
They will.
They
and
will.
Much quicker.
100%.
But it wasn't bad getting it up, because I know how to get it up the stairs, but it's just the idea of it. Because, yeah, then you're
sucks.
Just, oh, my God.
Because you're, like, thinking, oh, God, man, I'm gonna save some money. I want to be smart. But when you're doing it, it's 4 hours of torture. It's like I could have spent
it.
For an extra $12 an hour. My time is worth more than $12 an hour.
So you go time and money, and then you start going with
injuries.
Money and injuries.
100%.
So, okay, which way do I want to go? I'll spend the money.
So Beth and I are very good project doers together. Like, we don't argue really at all. I mean, we just really don't, because I know my role. I know that
I was going to say, it's just that you just shut up.
But I do. I just shut up. We're in the middle of doing it, and we, I don't remember what we were doing. She was pushing the stand-up little brush deal, and I'm going behind her getting the cracks.
Wish we had video.
I don't know. Oh, you don't want that video. So at one point, we're like, we're not getting frustrated with each other. We're getting frustrated with the project, because we're like an hour and a half in and we've done four boards.
Yeah.
Just pissed. And so she's like, she starts giving me direction on how to do what I'm doing. And I'm like, well, I don't know. I've never done this before. She goes, I haven't either. I said, do you want to do it? She looks at me and she goes, I really don't want you to be doing any of this. Like, okay. I'm like, well, I don't want you to be down here doing it by yourself. She's like, well, okay.
That's a problem.
I really don't want you doing any of this.
I don't want you doing any of this. And you're like, yeah, but I don't want you doing it by yourself. And she's like, I don't care.
Right. I prefer that. But it's
go count bricks, Pat.
Okay. And that's what's awesome, because that's what I feel like sometimes. And I told her this the other day. I'm like, sometimes I feel like you put me in the corner. And that little, it's funny that you said counting bricks. Because, yeah, she goes, you just want me to count the screw heads that are on the deck and I'll report back to you. She's like, do you want to? I'm like, no. Okay.
I think that'd be a fine idea. We should have all that inventoried right away.
Yeah.
Count the slits in the slats.
Uh-huh.
And then count the...
Oh, my God.
The screw heads. Oh, my God.
Now I know what a kid feels like when their parents just want to get them out of the way.
I don't... Do you think they know that?
Not the kids don't
they
know
don't,
that.
See,
no, they don't.
You do have the awareness to realize what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
So you should feel good about that.
I do, but I also have the smarts not to argue. I'm like, I'll just sit here and count screw heads. I'm good.
He doesn't care. He doesn't care. Oh, my God. So anyway, so you got it all stained?
Yeah, it looks awesome.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good deal. I got my fence fixed. Got my new gate put on. Really excited about that. Got the brick fixed.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm coming in another week. Is this the last week of April?
This is the last week of April.
Yeah, next week, they're coming out to power wash the house, and then they're going to paint it.
You're painting it?
Yep.
That's fun.
Changing the color of the...
You're not painting it.
Hell no.
There, again, when back I say, to our original conversation.
If I'm paying for it, I'm painting it.
Yeah.
So I'm in my world.
Yeah.
But yeah, going to change the colors of the shutters and the front. I'm painting the front door red.
Sweet. What?
Yeah.
What does that say? We should Google that.
I don't know what
I'm going to Google and see what happens. What does it mean when you have a red front door?
I just want to wake this house up, because it feels like it's been snoring. Just kind of like slumbering along for the last, I don't know, a few years. But yeah, red doors are popular.
Oh, a red door means welcome.
Thank you.
An old early American tradition. If a family had a red front door, tired travelers traveling by horse and buggy would know that that's a home. It's a welcoming place to rest.
So mom, pa, right? We're right back to that again.
They would be able, to spend the night there. So come on in, boys. Come on in, boys.
They say hang out your shingle, right?
Yep. You have a bright red shingle. Oh, my God.
Yep, I can't. I gotta find the names of the colors too because it's hilarious. They sent over some of the most popular colors that they've used for front doors that are red, mm-hmm. and sent over the ones to pick from. I'll bring those in.
I would love to be part of a naming process for colors.
Some of these are awesome.
Yeah,
I mean to work at Sherwin Williams and name paint.
Yeah, exactly.
I love it because it's hilarious. I don't have them with me, but if I did, I would tell you right now. But that's going to be happening in the next week.
So and I love it. People, I've been in the room when we used to work with Legacy Homes, and they were in the room trying to name their model, like not their models, name their, what are they called?
Floor plans.
Name a floor plan. And it's like everybody, and I'm sure it's like this in every business that names whatever menu items. They take it so seriously. It's like, dude, nobody knows the backstory. It doesn't have to be like this big, huge creative get consultants. And like, call it the freaking Brenda.
Right. And
it doesn't matter.
But when you see things like that are named like after like a first name, mm-hmm. I mean, I'm wondering what was the inspiration for that? Was somebody just at the end of the day?
Right.
And like, Karen, Barb.
Right.
Lucy, Cindy. That's it.
We're done. I want to go home.
Yep.
It's Friday.
So all good.
Yeah.
But I'm excited for that to get that done because now they got the brickwork done. They can power wash the house, clean everything up. I've got that like brick facade on the front of the house.
You're painting that too or no? Just the
wood part? Not going to paint the brick. I always love when JoJo paints the brick, but I know.
Chip and JoJo.
I always love when they do, but I know there's a real good opportunity to jack it up. Mm-hmm. And then what do you do?
Then you're screwed.
Yeah.
Just like with staining, if you stain wood wrong, you're screwed.
Yeah.
Yeah. You could paint over a paint screw up, but you can't, you'd have to sandblast the brick.
I know.
That'd be terrible.
I can't even imagine doing it. And I'd like to because I think it looks really cool when they paint it.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to do that.
Baby steps. Yeah. Red door for this year.
Red door.
Yep.
Red door.
Red door. And
here we go.
Gussy up that guest room. There's going to be a whole line of dudes out there.
Oh, I'm sure.
She's got a red door, finally.
I'm sure. I'm going to be the talk of the circle.
Yeah, you are already more than you already are. All right, you guys, thanks for listening to our podcast. 402-403-9478. Get to some texts next episode. They're coming in. Or you can go to Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. It's Pat and JT.
Pat and JT Podcast. A Huda Media Production.